The warning was issued by Vianney Mutyaba, manager pricing at the Electricity Regulatory Authority, while appearing before the ad hoc committee on Bujagali that is scrutinizing a proposal by the Minister of Finance to grant the power company another income tax waiver. He noted that the current domestic tariff, which is at 747.5 shillings per kilowatt hour, will increase to 800.4 shillings, which is at 7% increase if a waiver is not granted.
If you are interested in only the end user tariff and specifically for the domestic, the current domestic tariff is 747.5 shillings per kilowatt hour. If the waiver is not granted, the domestic tariff will increase to 800.4 shillings per kilowatt hour. That's for only domestic.
800 what?
800.4 shillings per kilowatt hour. An increase of 7.1%. That is for domestic.
This followed a question posed by the legislators who tasked government to explain the impact of not granting another tax waiver on charges Ugandans will pay for their electricity. Chivumbi wondered why electricity tariffs have remained high for the past 15 years. Bujagali Electricity Limited has enjoyed the tax waiver.
Can you tell us the impact if we remove, because the decision we're going to take as parliament is to remove a waiver and we save money. We want, given now this information you have given us, whether if you are in our shoes, you would continue, okay, to give this Bujagali a tax waiver. Because that's the animal in the house. That's the big issue.
So we also noted that there has been errors in the calculations of the tariff prices. And so that is where we are going into, and it will be part of our recommendations to Parliament.
Members on the ad hoc committee have also learnt with shock that at the end of the 30 years of the contract government signed with Bujagali, Bujagali Electricity Limited would have earned $2.014 billion, equivalent to 7.617 trillion shillings, despite the company investing just $176 million, which is about 670.1 billion shillings in the company.
We realize that the equity repayment and the return repayment on equity, which Bujagali shareholders are supposed to get, was based on the money that was invested in the project. But unfortunately, in 2015, all this money that was actually invested in the project was redeemed or was paid back. But the government continued to compute the payment to Bujagali based on the area formula or model, irrespective of the money having been got out of the company.
According to the Minister of Energy, based on the power production agreement formula, Bujagali is paid each month $5.596 million per month, which is about 21.27 billion shillings. That will bring the total to $2.014 million in 30 years, which money is paid by electricity users on the national grid. The revelation angered lawmakers who lashed out at government for renegotiating a bad deal.
At the end of this whole process, we are going to Bujagali Power Limited takes away, and this is the public should know, this is money levied on my yaka, my meter. Okay? This is not money from taxes, from URA. The money you pay on your yaka, on your meter, Bujagali takes away a certain percentage. Every month for 30 years, it's going to be taking away every single month, $5.596 million.
Bujagali Electricity Limited only invested $179.8 million, and by 2015 they had redeemed all their preference shares and only retained $10 million in the business. However, they have earned the highest in the payments of its shareholders to a tune of $645 million.
What we are looking at is ultimately we want to see the people of Uganda have tariffs that are reasonable, the manufacturers have tariffs that are reasonable that can reduce the cost of doing business and ultimately lead to growth of our economy.
The Minister of Finance, Matia Kasaija, who recently admitted that the Bujagali deal was a bad deal, during this meeting asked the committee to unearth all individuals behind this bad deal remaking.
We would have negotiated a reasonable interest. But for equity, which is in the business, you are removing all the funds and taking out virtually all the profits. You don't even pay income tax. So that is the annoying point I'll share with you.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.